stopped collecting tax from Christians,
okay,
so that they can still, and he's going to bring justice to the world.
Okay,
this is the only good point. He just picked it up from the Bible.
Yes,
but this is the their view and they believe about his second coming. It's
now,
unbelievable.
Mark, your newest book is this one here called Jesus and Muhammad. This has just come out. The subtitle, Profound Differences and Surprising Similarities.
Similarities.
Let's start with those. There's some similarities between Jesus and Muhammad?
There is some similarities, and it's funny similarities. You see, you will amaze when you hear about it. It's not similarities in the goodness of God. No. It's just a normal similarities like the way he grew up, the way he was acting when he was a little child. Like, for example, Islam speaks as Jesus, as the Bible told us about prophecy, prophesied about the coming Messiah. The Islamic side, they say there is prophecy, prophesied about the coming final prophet.
Okay.
When Jesus, he was a little boy and
yes.
just go to the temple every time.
Yes, Simeon prophesied.
Exactly,
yes.
Yeah. Exactly. Simeon prophesied over him. There is another Arabian guy, his name Waraka bin Naufal. It was the cousin of his first wife.
Yes.
They said he prophesied about his coming.
Okay.
About Jesus going to the temple and debating the Jewish leaders, religious leaders. Muhammad, he go to the center of the religious center of Mecca, called Al-Kaaba at that time, debating with religious people. Or you see the so there is some similarities like that. Jesus chose 12 disciples to spread his message. Muhammad chose 12, we can say, friends or 12 leaders to lead his army and his military in exporting Islam out of Arabia.
So you're really talking about some similarities that are not really all that significant.
Exactly.
But the contrasts are something else. And to get into those contrasts, tell us a story of the Muslim woman that you met in South Africa.
Very deeply. Jesus Christ came to bring hope, to bring forgiveness, to bring peace and love. Muhammad came to bring revenge, hatred, lust, killing, bloodshed. It's a very obvious. Like, for example, Jesus Christ, as the Bible telling us in John chapter 8 about the woman who was committed adultery and brought to Jesus by the Jewish people. Jewish people, they knew at that time that this woman, according to the law of Moses, she will be stoned. But they came to test this great preacher and teacher in Jerusalem. What are you going to say about that? And you know the story. He confronted them. He asked them, if any one of you live with no sin, just come and stone her. They, because they knew the fact about themselves that they are sinners, they left the woman in front of him and they just walked away. Jesus came to the woman and asked her, there is any one of you, these people, judge you? She said, no. He said to her, even me, go back and sin no more. In other words, Jesus, by what he did and said to this woman, he fulfilled his word that the Son of Man came not to kill or to destroy, but to give life. That he is the way, he is the truth, he is the life. He
now
came to
happened?
Bring life.
What happened when a woman in adultery was brought to Muhammad?
It's the history repeated itself in an amazing way when 600 years later Muhammad received Muslim woman adultery, Muslim woman was commit adultery. And the reason that Muslim brought her to him because the Islamic judgment of adultery wasn't established yet in Islamic law. So Muhammad asked the woman, do you really commit adultery? She said, yes, Prophet, and I'm pregnant now. And he asked her, fine, go back home, wait till you deliver your baby, and wait with your baby, nursing him or her, and for 2 years, and then bring your baby and come back to me. She did. She delivered the baby. She nursed the baby for 2 years. And she carried her baby, and she gave the baby a little piece of bread, you see, to eat it, just to show Muhammad that the baby, he can eat now. He is not in need for milk, for nursing anymore. When she came to him, Muhammad took the child from her, commanded his friend to dig a hole in the ground, They put her in hole. Only her head was above the ground. They stoned her and killed her in front of her baby.
Now, folks, let me tell you something very amazing about this. When Mark was in South Africa, he was living with a Christian family, and they invited him to go meet with a Muslim woman they had met who was living in abject poverty. And when he went in there, she was greatly honored when she found out he had been a professor at Al-Azhar University. Oh, she was so honored. And she began to honor him. And he said, well, you don't understand. I'm not a Christian anymore. I mean, a Muslim anymore. I have become a Christian. Then she was astonished and upset. And she asked him why he would leave the Islamic religion. And he told her the story. He told her the story about Jesus and Muhammad. This story he just told you, he told us that story. And the woman began to weep and weep and weep. And he said, why are you sobbing? She said, I am that woman. I am that woman. I am living here in abject poverty because I committed adultery. My family's trying to kill me. I'm hiding out. I want Jesus. I don't want Muhammad. And through the telling of that story, she accepted Jesus.
She accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. He delivered her baby. Her baby was baptized in Baptist church. And we just praise the Lord for that.
The whole book, Jesus and Muhammad, that tells stories about amazing parallels between the life of Muhammad and Jesus, where they had similar situations, and shows the difference in the way in which they responded to them. Mark, our time is almost up. We have just about 1 minute. Would you just look directly in the camera and talk to any Muslim who may be watching this program? What would you say to any Muslim?
I would like to say to any Muslim man or woman in any place around the world, Islam will not give you peace. Muhammad will never lead you to a right way to connect with God and to experience His love, His forgiveness, His peace. There is only Jesus Christ can give you the peace in your life, can forgive your sin, because He is the Lord of Lords, He is the Prince of Peace, He is the Forgiver, He the one came to tell us about the secret of heaven, He is the one came to connect us with the God Father. Muslims, man or woman, please think carefully about your life first, the condition where you live under, look about the miserable life which Muslims living in any part around the world, hatred, bloodshed, killing, conflict, terrorist, there is only way for you to get out of this mess is just to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior. And by meeting with Him face to face, you're going to experience the gift which you're going to receive through Him. Your sin will be forgiven. Your heart will fill with love. And you're going to experience the forgiveness. And you're going to feel and experience the freedom from sin and from the bondage of Satan. And you're going to find your way to God. And you're going to find you are in the right place. I pray for you and the power of my Lord Jesus Christ, able to reach your heart in the same way He did with me.
I want to thank you for tuning in this week. I hope the program has been a blessing to you, and I hope you'll be back with us next week. Until then, this is Dave Reagan speaking for Lamb and Lion Ministries, saying, look up, be watchful, for our redemption is drawing near.
What does the Quran really teach about Christianity? Does Islam promote violence? What's the goal of the Islamic holy war? Former professor of Islamic history at one of the world's most prestigious Islamic universities, Dr. Mark Gabriel, has answers to these and other important questions in his book, Islam and Terrorism. In his book, you will learn of Dr. Gabriel's journey from the ivory towers of respect and honor to the torture chambers of the Egyptian police. You'll also see one of the most dramatic exhibits of the contrast between Islam and Christianity, demonstrated by Mark Gabriel's desire for Muslims to be freed from the tyranny, religious confusion, and violence of Islam. Today, so many voices in secular media would have you believe that Islam isn't to blame for terrorism around the world. But Dr. Gabriel points out in a clear, logical manner that the mission of Islam is not satisfied with anything less than world domination. Islam and Terrorism is available for a gift of $15 or more. Just call and request Islam and Terrorism.
Thank you for joining us on today's Christ in Prophecy, a presentation of Lamb and Lion Ministries, a non-denominational ministry dedicated to teaching the fundamentals of biblical prophecy and proclaiming the soon return of Jesus.